It's Dhamma Dina, Vipassana Center, Joshua Tree, Retreat Number 5, March the 11th, 2010. The sutta is Sister Khema doing the six sets of six from the Majjhima Nikaya, number 148, the Chachakka Sutta. Thus I have heard, on one occasion the Blessed One was living at Sawati in Jetta's Grove, Anathan Pandika's Park, and there he addressed the bhikkhus thus. Monks, Venerable Sir, they replied, the Blessed One said this, Monks, I shall teach you the Dhamma that is good in the beginning, good in the middle, and good in the end, with the right meaning and phrasing. I shall reveal a holy life that is utterly perfect and pure. That is the six sets of six. Listen and attend closely to what I shall say. Yes, Venerable Sir, the monks replied. And the Blessed One said this. The six internal bases should be understood. The six external bases should be understood. The six classes of consciousness should be understood. The six classes of contact should be understood. The six classes of feeling should be understood. The six classes of craving should be understood. The six internal bases should be understood, so it was said, and with reference to what was this said. There are the eye base, the ear base, the nose base, the tongue base, the body base, and the mind base. So it was with reference to this that it was said the six internal bases should be understood. This is the first set of six. The six external bases should be understood. So it was said, and with reference to what was it said? There are the form base, the sound base, the odor base, the flavor base, the tangible base, the mind base. So it was in reference to this that it was said the six external bases should be understood, and this is the second set of six. The six classes of consciousness should be understood. So it was said, and with reference to what was this said? Dependent on the eye and form, eye consciousness arises. Dependent on the ear and sounds, ear consciousness arises. Dependent on the nose and odors, nose consciousness arises. Dependent on the tongue and flavors, tongue consciousness arises. Dependent on the body and tangibles, body consciousness arises. Dependent on mind and mind objects, mind consciousness arises. And so it was with reference to this that it was said the six classes of consciousness should be understood. And this is the third set of six. The six classes of contact should be understood. So it was said, and with reference to what was this said? Dependent on the eye and forms, eye consciousness arises. The meaning of the three is eye contact. Dependent on the ear and sounds, ear consciousness arises. The meaning of the three is ear contact. Dependent on the nose and odors, nose consciousness arises. The meaning of the three is nose contact. Dependent on the tongue and flavors, tongue consciousness arises. The meaning of the three is tongue contact. Dependent on body and tangibles, body consciousness arises. The meaning of the three is body contact. Dependent on mind and mind objects, mind consciousness arises. The meaning of the three is mind contact. And so it was with reference to this that it was said the six classes of contact should be understood. And this is the fourth set of six. The six classes of feeling should be understood. So it was said, and with reference to what was this said? Dependent on the eye and forms, eye consciousness arises. with the meeting of the three, there is eye contact. With eye contact as condition, there is eye feeling. Dependent on the ear and sounds, ear consciousness arises. With the meeting of the three, there is ear contact. With ear contact as condition, there is ear feeling. Dependent on the nose and odors, nose consciousness arises. With the meeting of the three, there is nose contact. With nose contact as condition, there is nose feeling. Dependent on the tongue and flavors, tongue consciousness arises. With the meeting of the three, there is tongue contact. With tongue contact as condition, there is tongue feeling. Dependent on the body and tangibles, body consciousness arises. With the meeting of the three, there is body contact. With body contact as condition, there is body feeling. Dependent on the mind and mind objects, mind consciousness arises. With the meeting of the three, there is mind contact. With mind contact as condition, there is mind feeling. So it was with reference to this that it was said the six classes of feeling should be understood. And this is the fifth set of six. The six classes of craving should be understood. So it was said. And with reference to what was this said? Dependent on the eye and forms, eye consciousness arises. The meaning of the three is eye contact. With eye contact as condition, there is eye feeling. With eye feeling as condition, there is eye craving. Dependent on the ear and sounds, ear consciousness arises. The meaning of the three is ear contact. With ear contact as condition, there is ear feeling. With ear feeling as condition, there is ear craving. Dependent on the nose and odors, nose consciousness arises. The meeting of the three is nose contact. With nose contact as condition, there is nose feeling. With nose feeling as condition, there is nose craving. Dependent on the tongue and flavors, tongue consciousness arises. The meeting of the three is tongue contact. With tongue contact as condition, there is tongue feeling. With tongue feeling as condition, there is tongue craving. Dependent on the body and tangibles, body consciousness arises. The meeting of the three is body contact. With body contact as condition, there is body feeling. With body feeling as condition, there is body craving. Dependent on the mind and mind objects, mind consciousness arises. The meaning of the three is mind contact. With mind contact as condition, there is mind feeling. And with mind feeling as condition, there is mind craving. And so it was with reference to this that it was said the six classes of craving should be understood. This is the sixth set of six. The demonstration of not self. If anyone says the I is self, that is not acceptable. The rise and the fall of the I is seen and understood. And since its rise and fall is discerned, it would follow myself rises and falls. That is why it is not acceptable for anyone to say the I is self. And thus the I is not self. If anyone says, I forms ourself, that is not acceptable. The rise and fall of the forms are seen and understood, and since their rise and fall is discerned, it would follow myself rises and falls. That is why it is not acceptable for anyone to say, I forms ourself. Thus the I is not self. Forms are not self. If anyone says I consciousness is self, that is not acceptable. The rise and fall of I consciousness is seen and understood, and since its rise and fall are discerned, it would follow myself rises and falls. That is why it is not acceptable for anyone to say I consciousness is self. Thus the I is not self. Forms are not self. I consciousness is not self. If anyone says eye contact is self, that is not acceptable. The rise and fall of eye contact is seen and understood. And since its rise and fall are discerned, it would follow myself rises and falls. That is why it is not acceptable for anyone to say eye contact is self. Thus I is not self. Forms are not self. Eye consciousness is not self. Eye contact is not self. If anyone says, I feeling is self, that is not acceptable. The rise and fall of I feeling is seen and understood. And since its rise and fall are discerned, it would follow myself rises and falls. And that is why it is not acceptable for anyone to say, I feeling is self. Thus, the I is not self. Forms are not self. I consciousness is not self. I contact is not self. I feeling is not self. If anyone says I craving is self, that is not acceptable. The rise and fall of I craving is seen and understood. And since its rise and fall are discerned, it would follow myself rises and falls, and that is why it is not acceptable for anyone to say that I craving is self, and thus the I is not self. Forms are not self. I consciousness is not self. I contact is not self. I feeling is not self. I craving is not self. If anyone says the ear is self, that is not acceptable. The rise and fall of the ear is seen and understood, and since its rise and fall are discerned, it would follow myself rises and falls. And that is why it is not acceptable for anyone to say that the ear is self, and thus the ear is not self. If anyone says that sounds are self, this is not acceptable. The rise and fall of sounds are seen and understood. And since their rise and fall are discerned, it would follow that myself rises and falls. And that is why it is not acceptable for anyone to say that sounds are self. And thus the ear is not self, and sounds are not self. If anyone says I consciousness is self, that is not acceptable. The rise and fall of ear consciousness is seen and understood. And since its rise and fall are discerned, it would follow myself rises and falls. And that is why it is not acceptable for anyone to say ear consciousness is self, and thus the ear is not self. The sounds are not self. The ear consciousness is not self. If anyone says ear contact is self, that is not acceptable. The rise and fall of ear contact is seen and understood, and since its rise and fall are discerned, it would follow myself rises and falls. And that is why it is not acceptable for anyone to say ear contact is self. Thus the ear is not self. Sounds are not self. Ear consciousness is not self. Ear contact is not self. If anyone says ear feeling is self, that is not acceptable. The rise and fall of ear feeling is seen and understood, and since its rise and fall are discerned, it would follow myself rises and falls. And that is why it is not acceptable for anyone to say that ear feeling is self. Thus the ear is not self. Sounds are not self. Ear consciousness is not self. Ear contact is not self. Ear feeling is not self. If anyone says ear craving is self, that is not acceptable. The rise and fall of ear craving is seen and understood. And since its rise and fall are discerned, it follows myself rises and falls. And that is why it is not acceptable for anyone to say ear craving is self. Thus the ear is not self. Sounds are not self. Ear consciousness is not self. Your contact is not self. Your feeling is not self. Your craving is not self. If anyone says the nose is self, that is not acceptable. The rise and fall of the nose is seen and understood, and since its rise and fall are discerned, it follows myself rises and falls. That is why it is not acceptable for anyone to say the nose is self, and thus the nose is not self. If anyone says odors are self, that is not acceptable. The rise and fall of odors are seen and understood, and since their rise and fall is discerned, it follows myself rises and falls. That is why it is not acceptable for anyone to say odors are self, and thus the nose is not self. Odors are not self. If anyone says nose consciousness is self, that is not acceptable. The rise and fall of nose consciousness is seen and understood, and since its rise and fall are discerned, it follows myself rises and falls. And that is why it is not acceptable for anyone to say nose consciousness is self. Thus the nose is not self. Odors are not self. Nose consciousness is not self. If anyone says nose contact is self, that is not acceptable. The rise and fall of nose contact is seen and understood. And since its rise and fall are discerned, it follows myself rises and falls. And that is why it is not acceptable for anyone to say nose contact is self. And thus, the nose is not self. Odors are not self. Nose consciousness is not self. Nose contact is not self. If anyone says nose feeling is self, that is not acceptable. The rise and fall of nose feeling is seen and understood, and since its rise and fall are discerned, it follows myself rises and falls. And that is why it is not acceptable for anyone to say nose feeling is self. Thus nose is not self. Odors are not self. Nose consciousness is not self. Nose contact is not self. Nose feeling is not self. If anyone says nose craving is self, that is not acceptable. The rise and fall of nose craving is seen and understood, and since its rise and fall are discerned, it follows myself rises and falls. And that is why it is not acceptable for anyone to say nose craving is self. Thus nose is not self. Odors are not self. Nose consciousness is not self. Nose contact is not self. Nose feeling is not self. Nose craving is not self. If anyone says the tongue is self, that is not acceptable. The rise and fall of the tongue is seen and understood, and since its rise and fall are discerned, it follows myself rises and falls. That is why it is not acceptable for anyone to say the tongue is self. Thus the tongue is not self. If anyone says flavors are self, that is not acceptable. The rise and fall of